Halliday, Resnick Walker, Chapter 2, Question 43, is one of my all-time favourite physics problems. So we have this locomotive, that's a small service train, that's mistakenly entered the train tracks and is travelling at 8.06 metres per second and doesn't realise that a high-speed train is approaching it from behind at 44.7 metres per second. The engineer of the high-speed train sees the locomotive when it's 676 metres ahead and applies the train's brakes, and we need to calculate the deceleration that the train needs in order to just avoid a collision. Let's first set up our model. We need to choose which direction to make positive, and of course we'll choose the direction the trains are both travelling in. I'm going to set time t equals zero to be when the engineer of the train first applies the brakes, and the origin to be the location on the tracks of the front of the train at that time, but we could just as easily choose an origin based on the locomotive instead. Let's see what we have for the train, which I'll show with a subscript t and an orange text. x0t is zero because of where we just placed the origin. Its initial velocity is 44.7 metres per second, and if a collision is to be avoided, its final velocity must be the same as the locomotive. Many students assume that the final velocity of the train must be zero, but it only needs to slow down to the same velocity as the locomotive, because it's decelerating, so after that time it will be travelling slower than the locomotive and thus unable to collide with it. We need to calculate the train's acceleration, and for that we'll use the equations of motion which are very common in high school physics. We're not told anything about its time or displacement, but in a problem of this level, we often need to bring variables into our calculations which aren't stated in the question. Now let's look at the locomotive. Its x0 is 676 metres, since it starts that far ahead of our chosen origin at time t equals zero. We'll model the rear of the locomotive, since that's the part which would collide with the train if it were to. The locomotive has zero acceleration, so it doesn't really make sense to give it an initial velocity v0 or a final velocity v. It just has a constant velocity of 8.06 metres per second, which I'll call vl for v-locomotive. Since it doesn't have acceleration, the only equation we can model it with is velocity equals displacement over time, so we're definitely going to need to use time and displacement in our equation somewhere. And since we need them for the locomotive, we'll probably need them for the train as well, and connecting these variables is the key to solving this problem. So where can we go from here? If the train decelerates at the minimum rate possible so that it doesn't quite collide with the locomotive, then just as the decelerating train reaches the same velocity as the locomotive, its front, which we're modelling, will be at the same place, and thus have the same displacement as the rear of the locomotive, and this will happen at a time we'll call t. So, at that time, we can say xt equals xl. So now let's figure out the displacement of each as a function of time. For the locomotive, its displacement is fairly easy to model. It starts 676 metres ahead of the origin, and then each second it moves a further 8.06 metres away. I suggest just thinking about this intuitively, but if you'd like to use a formula, we could use this one. The last part is zero because the acceleration is zero. We can also use this formula for the train, but now x0 is zero because we set the origin to be where the front of the train is at t equals zero. That's the moment the engineer applies the brakes. Substituting the numbers in, we get this. Since the displacement must be the same at time t, we can now make these equations equal, giving us this. Now it may look like we're almost there, but we have two unknowns, a and t, and only one equation, so this is unsolvable as it is. But all is not lost. When we get stuck at a point like this, it's a good idea to find a known variable we haven't used, try to somehow bring it into the equation, and use it to eliminate one or more of the unknowns. And we haven't used the final velocity of the train. Now, if we could eliminate time, then we could just solve the equation for acceleration, which is what the original question asks for. But because time appears three times and acceleration appears only once, it's probably easier to eliminate acceleration, even though we'll have to solve for it again at the end. So let's rearrange this formula, which is commonly simplified to this, to make acceleration the subject, and then insert it here. That gives us this equation, which now only contains one unknown variable, time, which we can then simplify and solve for t. Then finally, we just use the same equation, substitute in the value we just calculated for time, and solve it for acceleration. The answer is of course negative, because the train is decelerating, but because the original question asks for the magnitude of the deceleration, we should drop the negative. And, of course, we should round it to three significant digits, because that's how many are given in the original question. That gives us a magnitude for the acceleration of 0.993 meters per second squared. Part B asks for a sketch of displacement time graphs for the train and the locomotive. Please remember that your graph, or your teacher's, might be different if you chose the origin to be somewhere else, and wherever you choose it to be, it should be stated clearly in your solution. When sketching a graph, I always start with what we know, which in this case is that the train and the locomotive will almost collide after 36.9 seconds. Let's start with the locomotive. It starts with a displacement of 676 metres in our model and has constant speed, which on a displacement time graph is of course represented by a straight line. The train starts with a higher speed than the locomotive and decelerates, reaching the same speed and almost the same displacement as the locomotive at t equals 36.9 seconds. It will then continue to decelerate until it stops, which is represented on this graph as a flat line. But what if a collision were not quite avoided? The motion of the locomotive would be the same, since the driver never reacts to the situation, but the magnitude of the deceleration of the train would be lower, so it would travel further in the same amount of time, causing it to collide with the locomotive. So its line would briefly meet the line of the locomotive, representing a collision. If you're watching this in 2021, you might notice this is a new channel. I'd really like to help students understand physics concepts, so if you have any questions or suggestions for new videos, please ask in the comments. And if you found this helpful, please consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.